بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
السلام عليكم, respected brothers and sisters. Welcome to the 19th day of Ramadan. The selected verses of today from Surah An-Nur, verses 54, 55, and 59. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول فإن تولوا فإنما عليه ما حمل وعليكم ما حملتم وإن تطيعوه تهتدوا وما على الرسول إلا البلاغ المبين وعد الله الذين آمنوا منكم وعملوا الصالحات ليستخلفنهم في الأرض كما استخلف الذين من قبلهم وليمكنن لهم دينهم الذي ارتضى لهم وليبدلنهم من بعد خوفهم أمنا يعبدونني لا يشركون بي شيئا ومن كفر بعد ذلك فأولئك هم الفاسقون وأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة وأطيعوا الرسول لعلكم ترحمون. Respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, before these verses, He mentioned three things. He mentioned دلائل التوحيد, the proofs and evidences of monotheism is the right doctrine to believe in. As when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about a group of people during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they believed by their tongues and they disbelieved by their hearts. As when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the behavior and attitude and the response of the believers towards the call of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after that He talked about the obedience of Allah and the obedience of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and there is no difference between the obedience of Allah and the obedience of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So among the proofs and the evidences of monotheism is the right doctrine to believe in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated, أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Haven't you seen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is being exalted within the heavens and the earth? وَالطَّيْرُ صَافَّاتِ. And the birds with their splendid wings. كُلٌّ قَدْ عَلِمَ صَلَاتَهُ وَتَسْبِيحَهُ. Everyone got to know the way to pray and the way to exalt Him, the Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِمَا يَفْعَلُونَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all-knowing of what are they doing. وَلِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the dominion of the heaven and the earth. وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ وَإِلَيْهِ الْمَصِيرُ. And you will return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the final destination will be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about His blessings upon us, the sending down of the water from the heaven. وَيُنَزِّلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مِنْ جِبَالٍ فِيهَا مِنْ بَرَدٍ فَيُصِيبُ بِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَصْرِفُهُ عَمَّنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who sent down from the sky the mountains of clouds within hail. Then He is the one who strikes with it whom He wills, and He is the one who averts it from whom He wills. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about the alternation of the day and the night. وَيُقَلِّبُ اللَّهُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who alternates the day and the night. إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَعِبْرَةً لِأُولِي الْأَبْصَارِ. Within that phenomena is a lesson for those who have a vision. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about His creation. وَاللَّهُ خَلَقَ كُلَّ دَابَّةٍ مِّمَّا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created every living creature from water. فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَمْشِي عَلَى بَطْنِهِ. Among these creatures, the one who moves on its bellies. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَمْشِي عَلَى رِجْلَيْنِ. And among them, who walks upon two legs. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَمْشِي عَلَى أَرْبَعٍ. Among them, who walks on four legs. يَخْلُقُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates whatever He wants. وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over all things He's competent. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ وَاللَّهُ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed distinct verses. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who leads whom He wants to the straight path. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after that talked about the hypocrisy and the hypocrites within the community of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated about them, وَيَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالرَّسُولِ وَأَطَعْنَا. They say, we believe in Allah and we believe in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we are willing to obey. Not only willing to obey, وَأَقْسَمُوا بِاللَّهِ جَهْدَ أَيْمَانِهِمْ لَإِنْ أَمَرْتَهُمْ لَيَخْرُجُونَ. They swore by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the strongest of their oath, that if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered them to go out and strive for the sake of Allah, they will do. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded to them, قُلْ طَاعَةٌ مَعْرُوفًا. Such obedience is well known by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is well acquainted with what are you doing. So the ta'a is not only by tongue. Ta'a is well proven by the deeds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala criticized them because when they had been called for by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to judge among them, إِذَا فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. A part of them, they will turn away. They don't like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to judge, to be the judge among themselves, even though it is a part of the iman. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. By your Lord, they will not be believers. حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِيمَّا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. Until they make you a judge among themselves for whatever might comes up or appear among themselves. ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِّمَّا قَضَيْتَ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. And they will not find in themselves any rejection or any bad feeling about your judgment. So complete satisfaction and complete approval for the judgment of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they have to completely submit themselves to the order of Allah and to the order of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also talked about themselves. وَإِن يَكُنْ لَهُمُ الْحَقُّ يَأْتُوا إِلَيْهِ مُذْعِنِينَ. But if they think the right is theirs, they will come with complete prompt obedience to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Meaning, if they think the right is theirs, they have no doubt to come to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because they know he will give them their rights. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala questioned them. Well, he knows the best, the answers for these questions. أَفِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ. Is there any disease in their hearts? Which is very obvious. Yes, they have. But the disease in their hearts is the disease of hypocrisy. أَمْ يَرْتَابُوا. And they are in doubt. Because one main attribute of hypocrisy is being hesitant. When he is to the right, he thinks the left is the winners. And when he attend with the left, he thinks the right is the winners. And being unstable. Why? Because of greediness and selfishness. He is not stable, can't be. مُذَبْذَبِينَ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ لَا إِلَى هَؤُلَاء وَلَا إِلَى هَؤُلَاء. They are hesitant between being with the Muslims and between being with the disbelievers. وَإِنْ يَكُنْ لَهُمُ الْحَقُّ يَأْتُوا إِلَيْهِ مُذْعِنِينَ. أَفِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ أَمْ يَرْتَابُوا أَمْ يَخَافُونَ أَنْ يَحِيفَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَرَسُولُهُ. Or they might think that Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they will not be fair in the way they will make the judgment between them and the rest of the Muslims. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concluded, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. They are the wrongdoers. They are wrongdoers because the first one afflicted by their injustice is themselves. They preferred the short pleasure upon the everlasting one. They preferred this life upon the life of the hereafter. And they are definitely zalimun, because they are willing to take the rights of others. They are not willing to give others their rights. The time they insist upon getting their own rights. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about the Muslims and the true believers with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِنَّمَا كَانَ قَوْلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ أَنْ يَقُولُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. On the other side, the attitude and the response of the believers with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they have been called to be judged for a conflict or a concern took place among themselves, then they respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah sallam by سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. We listen and we are going to do our best to obey. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. They are the winners. They are the successful ones. مُفْلِحُونَ from فَلَاح. They are the successful ones. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَيَخْشَى اللَّهَ وَيَتَّقْهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَائِزُونَ. And those who obey Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَيَخْشَى اللَّهُ, and fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the sins he committed, وَيَتَّقْهِ, and have taqwa for what is going to take place in the future. Meaning, he fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the past within the sins he committed, and he fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the remaining of his time. So he tries his best to do the good and to remain with full obedience with Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَائِزُونَ. They are the winners. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after that he stated, قُلْ أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ. Say to them, they have to obey Allah and they have to obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As I said, the obedience of Rasulullah is a part of the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا لِيُطَاعَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. We have not sent a messenger unless that messenger should be obeyed by the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. And whatever Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered you, you have to take it. And whatever Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam abstained you from, you have to stay away from it. Because he is approaching you by the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى. Whatever Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says about deen is not from himself. It is a revelation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed upon him. قُلْ أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّمَا عَلَيْهِ مَا حُمِّلَ وَعَلَيْكُمْ مَا حُمِّلْتُ. So the duty of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is to deliver the message, to offer clear notification of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعَلَيْكُمْ مَا حُمِّلْتُمْ. And your responsibility is the obedience. وَإِنْ تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا. But if you follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in whatever he orders you, then you will be rightly guided. وَمَا عَلَى الرَّسُولِ إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينُ. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is only accountable for the balagh, for delivering the message with clear notification. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, respected brothers and sisters, after that he talked about وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised to those who believed among you and they did good deeds, لَيَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كَمَا اسْتَخْلَفَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. That he will grant them succession of the earth the way he granted to those who preceded them, Dawood and Sulaiman, and those who came after that and those who were before this. كما استخلف الذين من قبلهم وليمكنن لهم دينهم الذي ارتضى لهم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will establish for them the religion that he preferred for them, the religion that he chose for them. إن الدين عند الله الإسلام. The considered religion from Allah's perspective on the Day of Judgment will be Islam. وَمَن يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَن يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ. And whoever chose a religion other than Islam on the Day of Judgment will not be accepted from him. وَلَيُمَكِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ دِينَهُمُ الَّذِي ارْتَضَى لَهُمْ وَلَيُبَدِّلَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ خَوْفِهِمْ أَمْنًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised them he will substitute for them. What? He will substitute for them the fear they have with security and safety. وَلَيُبَدِّلَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ خَوْفِهِمْ أَمْنًا يَعْبُدُونَنِي لَا يُشْرِكُونَ بِي شَيْئًا. For or because they believe in me, they do not associate a partner to me. وَمَنْ كَفَرَ بَعْدَ ذَٰلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. And those who disbelieve after that, they are defiantly the disobedient ones. Respected brothers and sisters, scholars of tafsir, they extracted from this verse a lot of lessons that consider the basics and very important for Muslim brothers and sisters to be aware of. The first thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from this verse, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mutakallim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had the ability and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does talk. But the way that matches the majesty and the honor and the dignity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not like his creatures, has a mouth, and within the mouth there is a tongue, and on the top of that there is two lips. Ma'ad Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, none similar to him. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does talk. Didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked to Musa alayhi salam with direct speech. As will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is well knower of everything. So the past and the present and the future for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are the same. There is no difference between the past and the future. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَحَاطَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is well aware of everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a promise to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that promise will take place in the future. And it came exactly the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That among those who believed in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did grant him the succession of the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did establish for them the religion. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala substituted for them their fear with safety and security. Didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did that with the khulafa ridwanullah alayhim? Yes, he did. And because of this, this is a proof that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Rasulullah. Because whatever Rasulullah sallam promised took place the way he promised. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala proved this by achieving his promise with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As well, scholars extracted from this verse that the approval of the Khilafah of the Caliphate and the Imamah of Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did mention that in the Quran, لَيَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كَمَا اسْتَخْلَفَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. And that was one of the promises of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because they were from the generation of Rasulullah sallam. They were among those who believed in Rasulullah, and they were among those who did good deeds. And if we think it is general for the Muslim Ummah in general, then you cannot accuse Abu Bakr or Umar or Uthman of transgression, because this is the right they are entitled for. As will respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. There is two conditions Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned: Iman, the faith, and amal salih, and good deeds. And because of this, scholars, they say Iman and good deeds, they are not one thing, they are two different things. Why? Because Iman is i'tiqad, and i'tiqad is in your heart. But amal salih is the translation of that i'tiqad by your acts and by your deeds. Therefore, Iman is completely different than the act. So, al-Iman wal-amal salih, two different things. As were respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered in this verse clearly such a status that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted the believers and those who carried good deeds with their iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stipulated, يَعْبُدُونَنِي لَا يُشْرِكُونَ بِي شَيْئًا. They worship me and they do not associate a partner to me. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, whoever become disbeliever after that, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala labeled them as defiantly, they are disobedient ones. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concluded this part by the same concept. وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. That you have to establish prayers and you have to give the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your wealth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala simulated the obedience of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ. Then what is going to be the reward for all of these? the reward will be لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. For sure, you will be granted the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Respected brothers and sisters, when you talk about salah, it is the act of worshipping that needs your time and your body. So you dedicate yourself for the salah. Because without dedicating the time and yourself, you cannot perform the salah. As well, when you give zakah, it is the share of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your wealth. And this is basically the price of Jannah. The price of Jannah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ. So the price of Jannah is to strive and you give away yourself, your body, as well you give away your wealth. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you Jannah because of this. So respected brothers and sisters, within the verses of today, we have to learn that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created in the universe the signs and the evidences and the proofs that none on the Day of Judgment will be excused from disbelieving in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and no one will be left without accountability that why didn't he or she did not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As well, we should clear and clean our hearts, especially from the act of hypocrisy. Because being a hypocrite, being nowhere, and hesitation will remain with you as long as you have this attribute. As well, we have to train ourselves with the obedience of Allah and the obedience of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because you will not be a good Muslim unless you submit yourself completely to the will of Allah and to the will of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the last point I'd like to mention is, Iman can be led by imitation or by proofs and evidences. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala criticized those who became mu'min or became disbelievers because of their imitation. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَوْمُ اتَّبِعُوا مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ قَالُوا بَلْ نَتَّبِعُوا مَا أَلْفَيْنَ عَلَيْهِ آبَانَا أَوَلَوْ كَانَ آبَاؤُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ شَيْءٌ وَلَا يَهْتَدُونَ. And if we say to them, come and follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed, they will say, no, we are following the footsteps of our parents. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned to them, أَوَلَوْ كَانَ آبَاؤُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ شَيْئًا وَلَا يَهْتَدُونَ. Even though their parents, they were not understanding, nor they were rightly guided. وكذلك ما أرسلنا من قبلك في قرية في وكذلك ما أرسلنا من قبلك في قرية من نذير إلا قال مترفوها إن وجدنا آباءنا على أمة وإن على آثارهم مقتدون. And likewise, there is no place that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent within a messenger unless the wealthy people among themselves, they will say, we have found our parents following a religion and we are going to follow the footsteps of our parents in that religion. Even the Prophet explained to them, قَالَ أَوَلَوْ جِيْتُكُمْ بِأَهْدَى مِمَّا وَجَدْتُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَبَاكُمْ. How about if I bring to you guidance better than what your parents used to bring to you? قَالُوا إِنَّا كَفَرْنَا بِمَا أُرْسِلْتُمْ بِهِ. They clearly illustrated and uttered. They said, we clearly disbelieve in whatever you have brought. Then what happened to them after that? فَانْتَقَمْنَا مِنْهُمْ فَانْظُرْ كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الْمُكَذِّبِينَ. We took retribution from them. We took our revenge from them because they were deniers. They didn't believe in whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. So respected brothers and sisters, جزاكم الله خيرا وغفر الله لي ولكم وتقبل الله مني ومنكم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.